If you're working on a real-world project, you're probably using external dependencies. You might need to analyze which dependencies your application uses. For example, you may want to find out how a particular version of a dependency ended up in your application. Let's take a look at how IntelliJ IDEA can help you to analyze dependencies. We can view our dependencies in the Maven tool window. Here we can expand dependencies to show their transitive dependencies, or collapse them again. We can open the Dependency Analyzer from the Maven tool window by clicking the Analyze Dependencies button. This will open the Dependency Analyzer, showing the resolved dependencies on the left and their usages on the right. Alternatively, we can right-click a dependency in the Maven tool window and select Analyze Dependencies from the context menu. This will open the Dependency Analyzer with the dependency selected. Let's hide all tool windows so we can focus. We can view the dependencies as a tree and expand or collapse them as needed. We can also click the View Options button and toggle whether we want to show Group IDEA or not. To see where we're getting a specific version of a particular library, we can search for that dependency. For example, when we search for log4j, we see that we're only getting it via this Spring Boot starter, and it's a version newer than the one where log4shell was fixed. Yay! We might only want to look at dependencies that have conflicts. When we select the Show Conflicts Only button, we see only dependencies that have conflicts. Here we see that there's a conflict with the Checker Framework dependency. Fortunately, it's been resolved. We see that one version is grayed out. If we go back to the Maven tool window, we see that this version has been omitted for conflict. We can see that the version we are using is 3.5.0, which we get from Postgres. We can also select a scope. For example, if we want to look at our test dependencies or exclude them from analysis. Since we've opened the Dependency Analyzer from the Maven tool window, we see the Maven scopes. When we open the Dependency Analyzer from the Gradle tool window, the list of scopes will contain Gradle scopes. For more context, we can click a specific dependency and select Open Maven Config to open its POM XML, or go to Maven Dependency to open the location in the POM XML where this dependency is declared. If you are using IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate, you can also view your dependencies as a diagram. Let's open IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate to have a look. We can open diagrams either by right-clicking the project in the Project Tool window and selecting Diagrams, Show Diagrams, or by using the shortcuts Option, Shift, Command and U on Mac, or Control Alt Shift and U on Windows and Linux. You'll notice this gives you several diagram options to choose from. In this case, we're interested in the Gradle dependencies. Let's hide all windows again so we can focus on the diagram. The project we're looking at pulls in a lot of transitive dependencies, so the diagram is quite large. We can zoom in and out using the plus and minus keys, or the plus and minus buttons in the diagram window. We want to look for a specific dependency and see where we get it from. We can search for a dependency using Ctrl and F to find it in the diagram. We can check the path for this dependency and click Related Dependencies to follow this path to the root. We have other options to look into specific dependencies. For example, we can zoom in on a specific dependency and the related nodes. Right-click the dependency you're interested in, and from the context menu, select Analyze Graph, Focus on Node Neighborhood. Let's look at both directions. When we are done, we can drop focus. We can also change the visibility level. For example, if we want to focus on compile or runtime dependencies. IntelliJ IDEA can help you analyze dependencies in multiple ways. Thanks for watching.